All right, 100 participants. I think we're ready to go. So yeah, hi everyone. Welcome to the Executor workshop. I'm Michael Pöhnl from Apex AI, and I'm super thrilled that we have so many participants in this workshop. And it's also a great honor for me to host a workshop with all these experts from the Rust community. So some of you may ask why we have a workshop about executors. So hasn't everything already been said? But let me try to summarize. There's a single-threaded executor, a multi-threaded executor. There's a static single-threaded executor that was presented by Nobleo at RustCon 2019. There's this callback group level executor, which is more or less an extension for all the other ones. We have this RCLC executor developed for MicroRust. And we had great talks from Ingo at RustCon 2019 and from Ralph at Rust Industrial 2020, where they introduced and explained all these different executors. But yeah, there's a lot of more activity. We have the event executor proposal driven by iRobot. So there's on Rust Discourse and the middleware working group. We had a lot of discussion the last year. Pablo reached out to us and said, okay, he is also developing an own Rust 2 executor. Jan wrote an email and said, hey, look, there's a pretty nice paper from the University of California, Riverside. They presented a chain-aware executor for Rust 2. And in Apex AI, we also develop our own executor. So you see that a lot of people are still working on improving the performance, determinism, and the real-time capabilities for Rust 2 execution. And this also shows that the executor is one of the most crucial components when it comes to using Rust 2 for production. So at RustCon 2019, we had two executors and two new were introduced. Today we have Rust World 21. We have four executors and four new will be introduced. So maybe should we avoid having eight executors at RustCon 2023 and introducing eight more? So the goals for this workshop are first understand how crucial the executors are for a Rust 2 system. Then get an overview of all the existing executors and their capabilities. We will introduce an infrastructure that enables us to compare different executor approaches. And the most important thing is trigger the discussion in the community. So we want to see what are the pain points, what are the needed features, why people are developing more and more executors, what are the use cases? And the question is, can we consolidate to have two or three different execution models? Or do we want to have a flexible architecture and have many executors? And where will this topic be addressed in future? In one of the existing working groups, or will there be a new one? So we planned a workshop as a full day and in-person workshop. And the plan was also to switch between talks and hands-on sessions and to use a Raspberry Pi setup so that the participants can step-by-step improve the system and using different Rust 2 executors, different configurations for them, tweaking the underlying system for real time, and also getting hands-on introduction to all the tools that are useful for analyzing such a system. But yeah, plans changed. Instead of an 8-hour workshop in person, we have now a 4-hour virtual workshop, and we'll come up with the following agenda. So we start with William, with the current status of executor in Rust 2. Then Evan will introduce an open source reference system that we are used for our talks and that everyone can use for getting their own experience with executors. Christoph will show us how we can analyze the reference system. Andre will present how we can tune the system for real time. Then Ralph will present how we can use thread priorities to ensure that we have enough priority for our critical paths in the reference system and how this can be improved with the callback group level executor. Alberto will present the events executor, Then we have a 10-minute break. And in the second part, Hyun Young will present the PCAS executor, Yan the RCLC executor. I will present the Apex executor that is based on a wait set and polling subscription. And then we have Pablo with a lock-free executor that's based on a ring buffer. And finally, we'll have a panel discussion where you can challenge all the presenters with the way forward. So we'll start with William. William is a software engineer at Open Robotics, and yeah, he will introduce the current status of executors in ROS2.